Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect to an EC2 instance from a Mac machine. I will create a Windows Server 2016 instance in Amazon AWS and connect to the instance by using a Mac machine. So I start the browser and then go to my AWS account. I will use an AWS student account for this demonstration. So I go to aws.amazon.com/education/aws-educate. Then I log in to my account. You can create an AWS Educate account if you are a student, as well as you can get free credit for a course if your professor creates a classroom and requests credit for students. I log in with my account. And then I go to my classroom. And then I go to this specific classroom and I continue. And then I log into AWS console. And that brings me to AWS Management Console. Now, if you are using a different type of account, for example, AWS free tier account or a regular AWS account, after you log in, it will bring you to AWS Management Console. From here, I will create a new Windows Server 2016 instance. So I go to EC2 or launch a virtual machine. I'm going to use the resources that are under free tier. So I select free tier only. And then from the available AMIs, I select the Windows Server 2016 AMI. Then on the instance type, I select the free tier eligible one, which is T2 Micro. And then go next. I need to be able to connect to the EC2 instance from my place. So the EC2 instance need a public IP address. So I make sure that the public IP address is assigned. And then there are other options such as shutdown behavior. The stop shutdown behavior will keep the instance when you shut it down and will stop using the EC2 resource. However, it will keep using the storage resource. There is an option which is called terminate. If you select terminate, when you shut down the machine, it will release all the resources and delete this instance as well. I want to keep it as stop and go next. On this screen, it shows the storage or hard drive space. A 30 gigabyte storage has been assigned to this server. And you can also see the default option of this storage under delete on termination option, which is checked. That means if you terminate this machine, this storage will be deleted. In production environment, if you want to keep your storage or hard drive with all your data, even if you delete the machine, then you should take this off. Alright, so I go next. Here I can add tags, and that can be useful to find resources by using tags. I will add a simple tag. Created from, and I will say Mac. This tag will be added to both instances and also with the volume or storage. So I go next. Here is a security group settings. I can use an existing security group or I can create a new security group. Now this security group defines different types of allowed connections. I will give a name to this security group. To connect to a Windows instance, RDP must be enabled, and also to be able to connect from any place such as your home or from your office, you can either select My IP or anywhere. When you select My IP and create this connection from home, then this connection will be allowed only from the IP of your home network when you created this connection. In that case, you may not be able to connect from your office. On the other hand, if you select anywhere, then it will not store any specific IP and thus will allow connection from anywhere. For this demo purpose, I will keep anywhere. It's giving me a security warning saying that allowing all IP is not secure because anyone from anywhere can try to connect to this instance. But that is okay for this demo purpose. So I review and launch, giving me the summary of this instance. I'm creating a Windows Server 2016. Instance type is T2 Micro, and then one EBS volume has been added. I'm allowing RDP connection, which is needed to connect over the internet. So I go and launch. And then it is asking to create a new key pair or choose an existing key pair. I'm going to create a new key pair here and give a name to this key pair. And I need to download and save this key pair. This key pair will be needed to get the login information such as password. So I must save it in a secure place. So the file has been downloaded, and then I go launch instance. Now I go view instances, and I can see that the instance status is initializing. When done, the status will check and it will show 2 of 2. Now there is other information about this instance. For example, I can see the public DNS information. I will need this public DNS information to connect to the instance over the internet, or I can also use this IP address to connect over the internet. I will download the necessary software to connect to this instance. So I will go to a new tab. I search remote desktop for Mac. And from the search result, I select the link from Microsoft. Then I select Mac App Store, download Microsoft Remote Desktop, and install it. When the installation is complete, I open the software. So I downloaded and installed Microsoft Remote Desktop 10. Now I try to open it. So I will add a new PC. Now I will get the information from Amazon AWS. While the Windows Server instance is selected, I go to Action, get Windows password. Then I choose the key pair file that I saved before. So I choose file, and this is the key pair, and choose, and then decrypt password. So I get the public DNS name and copy it. Go to Microsoft Remote Desktop. In the PC name, I paste the public DNS. And for the user account, I will add a new user account, and the username is administrator. And for password, I need to go to AWS again and get the password. Go back. So I add this username and password. I can select connect to an admin session, and I will give a name to this connection. And select add. So this connection information is saved. I can come back to Microsoft Remote Desktop anytime and select this connection to connect to the EC2 instance. Now I right click on the connection name and select connect, and it is prompting that I'm connecting to the Remote Desktop host, and I continue. Still it's loading. So I am at the EC2 instance, and I will start Server Manager. I can add different roles and features to this server and configure them according to what I want this server to perform. So I created an EC2 Windows instance in Amazon AWS and then connected to that instance from a Mac machine using Microsoft Remote Desktop for Mac. Now I will shut down this server, and that will take me back to the Mac machine. So I'm back to the Mac machine. If I need to connect again, I can double click on this connection name on the Microsoft Remote Desktop. All right, so I'm gonna close this Remote Desktop now and close this too. So in this demo, I created a Windows Server 2016 instance and connected from my Mac machine by using Microsoft Remote Desktop for Mac. And that is the end of this demo. I hope you found this video helpful. If you would like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and set up notification by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.